continue to track Imelda and Humberto today, and this is a classic case of the Fujiwhara effect. A lot of times people, they tend to look at the Fujiwhara effect, and you see two storms really close together, and the number one question I always get is, are these two going to merge and create a bigger storm? And I often say, you know, they kind of steal energy from each other, and that's what we're seeing out here today. You have Humberto on the right, you have Imelda on the left, and they're basically kind of interacting with each other. Humberto has dramatically weakened. Imelda, it is a hurricane at this time, but basically, I mean, this is about one of the ugliest hurricanes I have seen. If it wasn't for hurricane hunters going through and actually getting a reading on the storm, I almost guarantee this probably wouldn't have been upgraded. The point is, you know, these are interacting, it's slowly drifting towards north and east, but you have to remember, instead of them merging and becoming one big storm, they kind of steal the energy. And think of if you are digging a hole, and instead of you digging straight down, you have like kind of a steep gradient on the hole, you dig a trench. In a trench, you can kind of walk down. It's not quite as steep. And that's the case here. I know that's a really rough metaphor, but basically it's stretching out that gradient. So the general winds around both of these is lesser. It steals the energy. You don't get that good circulation. Outflow aloft is lost, and they have shear kind of interacting with each other, which in the end causes both to weaken. So a lot of times people say, are they going to merge and become a big storm? And usually when you have a Fujiwhara effect, that's not quite the case. It also makes the forecast a little bit tricky, as we have seen a very big testament to this storm system, especially Imelda, with the forecast originally heading out towards the Carolinas. Now it is making that hard right turn. Now, still too close for comfort for the East Coast in the sense of rough waves, rip currents that are going to continue to take place. And on the back side of this, we're also looking at a bit of a nor'easter as high pressure works its way in from the north and west and creates a bit of a tight pressure gradient. Bermuda is going to get a bit of a twofer, though. First, they're getting impacted today by Humberto, and then Imelda is going to kind of run off towards the east and run over Bermuda. Not looking at destructive winds, that island gets hit all the time, but they are under a hurricane watch at this time due to Humberto passing on by. There's a little gear spaghetti plots just giving you a general idea of that flow off towards the east, moving away from the east coast of Florida. Looking at that radar, you can see right here, yeah, we still got some coastal showers from this, but nothing too intense. And there is a solid breeze along the coast. And I say breeze because gusts are only about 20 to 25 miles per hour. Surf is the big thing, dangerous rip currents. I mean, look out just west of Bermuda, that's 17 feet. And we have some buoys just offshore of the first coast, that's the east coast of Florida, up to 10 to 13 feet. I was in the Navy. Anything over 10 feet is a solid stomach churner. So for any maritime, yeah, it's going to be rough out there, even for bigger ships. Meanwhile, yeah, here's a look at our outlook. And I like this because you can see that interaction. And basically, what happens here, too, is one storm almost starts to become a feeder band into the other storm. And it seems like that's what's happening with Imelda becoming a feeder band into Humberto. This is common in other basins around the world, but in the Atlantic, it's kind of rare. But so basically what we're seeing here is Humberto kind of just grabbing and sucking the energy from Imelda, and basically it just tears both of these storm systems apart in the end. So it's kind of interesting, still looking at some impacts for Bermuda, but good news, that is pulling Imelda away from the east coast of the United States. We still got some rough waves out there in the end. Yeah, not getting that full-on tropical storm strength type setup. Still, like I said, rough waves, rip currents, all of that stuff. And at firstcoastnews.com, we're going to have more information on all of this, as well as on FCN Plus. We're always streaming at 11 and 8 o'clock today. If you want a full 30-minute breakdown, longer look at what's happening out here. And on top of that, today is the anniversary of Hurricane Ian, so we're going to be talking about that too. So stop by. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, you can always shoot us here at First Coast News a message. And yeah, hopefully that kind of breaks this down. Try never to give you the hype, just the latest information, being transparent about what we see. And I can tell you right now, both of these storms are interacting with each other, but they're kind of messy. They're not organized, with Humberto weakening, Imelda now a hurricane, but the low end, and it's going to be moving off towards the east.